Good morning guys, it's Jenny here from Just Jenny Journaling. Welcome back to my channel. Quick flip through today, well, a bit of a different video. I've decided to just go through a flip through of my November day book. So it's just to share really, because I tend to do my day book as a sort of, you know, basic journal, different pages and decorate as we go. So it just gives you a bit of an idea share of different things you can do to decorate a page. So going to go through that, and then also some other bits and pieces that I'm going to have be working on over the next few weeks, so you have an idea what's coming up in the studio. So yes, what's interesting about this month is it's the first time that I have used pages from past books. So as you know, my autumn book for 2018, I just tied the pages in, and I did the same for last year, 2019, just tied the pages in. So some pages I hadn't used, and so I decided to go through and take out pages that I hadn't used that I really love, like this one. This was from 2018, and I absolutely loved this trim that I picked up in a local haberdasher's store, and they were selling it off at something like 50p a metre, and absolutely beautiful. So I popped it in my day book. And that was the signature cover, to be honest. And this was just some wrapping paper that I had in my stash. Love the colours. And I just love this image that I picked up from one of my, I can't remember, it might have been a diary that had like, you know, classic art in, you know, classic pictures. But look at the beautiful colours, the depth of colours in there, in that lovely painting. So that was from my first, so I've just popped it in, yeah. Just pop it in the front there. Got to clip it in. Keep it clipped in like so. Now, the front of this signature, I basically... So this is from October. So that was the old books from Lindsay Zenore, which I've used throughout. And I just love this beautiful poem about winter sunset. I love the colours of this picture. And, you know, when I woke up this morning, about 6:30, there was a mist, sunshine, very heavy autumn mist. And the colours, as I looked out into my garden, was like this. That's how it looked. So I'm glad I popped that in. So that's that. That's how I started off. This paper is from Amazon. As you know, it's already kind of distressed. It's a lovely weight, and I've used quite a lot of it in my projects in the last few months. This is from, I think, in my Digital Expressions CA, it is, on Etsy. And I've listed her on October, on my October video, the kit. So there are different, I printed out quite a lot, and I've used some in October, some in September as well. And I've used some, the last pieces I've used in this in November. This is from Daphne's diary. Can't remember when, to be honest, and I think that's on its way. The new one's on its way, so that'll be a video quite soon. So it's one of their little cards, and I just done it as a little flip through, just flip up. Put a Tracy Fox label on that. Love the colours. And stickers. That's just a stamp I found. That's one of my winter stamps, to be honest. A little cat on the cozy chair, and some papers that I found in my stash. I've just added to a few. It's beautifully textured, feels like old wallpaper, so I've popped that in. This is just like a little picture that I've got from a wallpaper book. This was from Lindsay's printout. That's from old books, the digital one. I just put a little stamp on there, a little postage stamp sticker. I just love the colours, really. That's for no other reason. Beautiful, isn't it? So found that in my stash, thought that had to go in. And I've just used stamps, number stamps for the days. Stickers from my stash. That's lovely. Stickers from my stash. These are probably from my ephemera boxes from the last couple of years. I've stashed them away. Little pocket here, haven't put anything in it yet. Haven't popped anything in that, but you know. Whatever I fancy, I'll go in there. This is a garden book. I think it's this one. My friend bought me this from the charity shop Find. Yes, a blooming smaller city dweller's garden it's called. And I just love the colours in that. And so, yeah, we've got a couple of pages. Unusual, it comes under October, November. But yeah, my hydrangeas are still going because we haven't had any really heavy frosts yet. I don't know what it's been like where you are. And decided that I wanted a couple of these little clothes pegs. I've just sold Accomplished, the vintage memoirs of an accomplished homemaker, and I've popped, instead of paper clips, I've popped all the little bits in with these. They're gorgeous, aren't they? Little mini clothes pegs. This page, oh, this is a little piece from one of my books from last year. And and just stickers. Love it. Stickers again. Got some stamps out. And my daughter's just finishing up her photography course, and we have been out and about over in October. It's been fabulous to have different ideas for photographs to go out and to walk and find them. So I've just popped a couple camera icons in, stamps in, just to remind us or to note down what we found on our walks. That's going to be fun. This, oh, I love it. So this is from the People's Friend book. Or is it the Fireside? Might be the Fireside book. And it's got all these lovely poems. So this is from the 80s, I think. But look at this. It's called The Curio Shop, the poem. But I just love, really, really adore this this image of this lady going out looking at in her little junk shops, because I love doing that as well. And a lot of my friends are like, Mindy, we love... In America, I suppose you call it thrifting, do you? But here, you know, we do like a bargain. We really do. So, just the colours, I thought I'd pop that in. This is the other side of that old books, digital, printable. It's lovely, and I've just printed it on a little bit, and it's kind of like a very heavy paper. So it feels a bit like card, but it's lovely. Love the colours. And this, I think, was from last year's. It might have been from the year before, from 2018. And I've moved it along, this page, this coffee. The idea is kind of, you know, coffee in bed, really, you know, snuggling down with the papers or whatever on a winter's morning. Anyway, I just love the way this looks. So I've tipped it in. That's from from one of last year's books. A bit of lace on the top. Stamping, a little bit, just a cutout from the wallpaper magazine, stamping onto a book page. So this is from last autumn. This is from this one. I hadn't used it. And so it's just basically stamping onto, this is like a vintage paper, vintage form I've picked up from Sharika at Postal Love. And so I thought, maybe I'll not put it in this one. And I've got a sticker here. I haven't decided what I'm going to do with that yet. So I've kind of popped it in. Please excuse the typo, the spelling mistake. I got all carried away with myself last year because I've got these little post-its. Does this come off? I put a few in. No, it doesn't come off. These little post-its from my vintage ephemera box, and I put Autumn Joy onto this page. So this is one of the older pages from last year. Love this, and did a bit of collaging, and so I just took the page out, thought I'd pop it in this year's and get some use out of it. This is one of last year's as well. I think November was it was all about fashion, and I did vintage fashion in my November daybook last year. And this is probably Mrs. Cogs, I imagine. Love that with the lace as well. Got a bit carried away with myself. Just a bit of stamping here. Again, this is from, these little bits of paper here is from last year. And this was as well. This was from one of my pages from last year that I've taken out. And because I love now, I love the look of the trees. You know, again, without the leaves, they look beautiful. And so I wanted to have a little nod to that in my November book. As you can see, I've done some stamping and it's just about the trees. A little bit of a sticker. This was from last year that I hadn't used. I didn't fill anything of the 26th of November. So I thought, you know what, I'll pop that in there. Put a bit of stamping underneath. Some of my tree stamps I've managed to get out. And just a bit of layering. Love this. This was from one of my ephemera boxes, I think. Tucked away. Love the colours. The centre page is, so that's the pumpkin latte, I think. Beautiful. Beautiful. That's from Etsy. Love that. That's from ephemera box. I thought, yeah, I had put this at the beginning of my book. And I thought I might just clip it there, or clip it like that. I haven't clipped it in yet, but that could look nice, like you're looking through a window. So that's just an idea that I haven't done anything with yet. So that's the poem to the picture, the curio shop. I love it. So that's popped in. It's really from my winter stamping, but I thought, you know, end of November, we're getting there, aren't we? We've already got our winter woolies out now of the attic. And I love this from that stamp set from last year. So I'll just pop that on there. Hot chocolates when you're out and about. Or even not. This is from Mrs. Cogs, found in my stash. And so I put it in. That's from the rainy days. Is it or stormy weather? I think it's called Stormy Weather, that kit. Not kit. It's not a kit. It's like a digital set. And it's beautiful. So I'll pop that in. I think that looks lovely. I haven't done anything with this yet, so I just thought I'd clip it in there for now. Love the colours. Such beautiful colours. This is from last year as well. This poem about bonfires. People with the bonfires and the burning the leaves and tidying up their gardens as, you know, at the end of the autumn. It's lovely, and so I put that in. And again, I think I have misspelled. I was on a roll with myself with the autumn stamp, wasn't I? And a poem about winter as well, as we will be, so end of December, it's when it's end of November, that's when it starts, isn't it? This is from the Digital Expression CA kit, printables. Love it. Graphic 45, and I've just did a little, got some more vintage fabric that just looked nice with that, with those colours. And finally, I just, so that's the Digital Expression CA again, but look, I thought, I'm really happy how that came out, so I popped the little stamp on, and the little saying, cold hearts, cold days, warm hearts. I think that looks really nice. Just a little bit of fabric there, and there we go. There we go, that's the end. That is the end, will be the end of my 2020 autumn book. Huge, bit alligator mouth. Said I wouldn't do it this year, but I have. But yeah, so that's that. So that's a flip through of that. Now I just wanted to, let's move this, share with you some other things that will be on the table. First and foremost, I don't know what you guys are planning, but I was thinking about my, starting my new winter day book. This was last year's. Do you remember we did a little series and it was just making from coffee boxes. From a coffee box, we made this, and I think I filmed most of this, actually, this process, even to tying in the pages, doing the cover. So if any of you fancy revisiting that video, I could actually, I don't know how I'll do it. How would I do it? It's on the playlist. I'll put down below which playlist it's on. And if you're under lockdown at the moment and have a few spare minutes, most of us still don't, do we, to be fair, you might like to get a coffee box of your own or a cereal box and follow along and make something like this. So anyway, This is last year's, what, last winter's. This winter, I've decided I'm going to take this book and I'm going to alter it. I'm going to alter it, and that's going to be my day book. I've already got bits and pieces that I want to pop in. This I love. It's from a calendar. So I want to pop that in. I think that's beautiful. So yeah, I'll be working on that. I'll be making that altered book. I might try and turn on the camera if I can while I'm doing different elements of that. And this one here, let me just see. Yeah, just to say, if you want to alter a book along with me, you need really to find something that's got the pages glued in like that for to keep them secure. My daughter's starting, or she's just finishing this week, a 5-week photography course on Zoom, and she's got lots of lovely photographs. And I thought, I've had this in my stash for ages. I'm going to alter this. I'm going to alter this and do it so she can put her pictures in it. So a lot of it's when we're out and about. So yeah, I'll be making that for her. Great way to for her to learn, so she can have just pages that she can look at and some that she can put her pictures in. It's fascinating, really. Yeah, so that's what we'll be doing. I'll be doing that. So I might do that off the camera because I want to do it quite quickly. She's got quite a few weeks now of photos to catch up on. Also, we'll be trying to finish off. I've got four of these. I can only find two to hand at the moment. I started these probably a couple of years ago. It's probably when I first opened my Etsy shop. And just haven't finished them. So they're filled with vintage Jackie pages. So these are from, these were from 1970s dress patterns at the front. But I had these Jackie, you know, Jackie magazine, 1970s and 80s. Yeah, so anyway, I just thought they are fun. They're just fun. I've cut the pages out. And just haven't done anything with them. So I think I really need to get these done. They're just fun for us ladies of a certain age. This will take us right back to our teens. So there are four altogether. I can only put my hand on two at the moment. So you know what? I'm going to work with these and get these listed. They're just such fun. Going to go over, so I've only glued those in. Going to go over them with some decoupage just to seal it all. So that needs to be done. And that's going to be on my table. I also have custom order, so I'll be working on a custom order for Randy, and that will be for a kind of vintage, she wants a vintage kind of country journal, botanical, like somebody who's journeying around England and looking at all the nature botanical type things. So that's starting that, that will be, and I'll probably do a little companion with it as well, so that will be spoken for. She's chosen this cover, do a little companion as well, I think. So that can be available. So that's it, guys. That's what that's my November day book, and also what's on my table. Hope you have a productive weekend and stay safe wherever you are. Take care. Bye-bye. Bye bye. Bye.